How to use the sequence selection and the ECG in 2D CPA. If multiple cardiac cycles have been acquired, proceed to the sequence M-mode selection icon and define one cardiac cycle with the period selector. In this case, we can see a blue line. That blue line indicates ECG information, which are transferred from the machine as a DICOM information. We can use them. Okay, first of all, let's play the loop using the toolbar and see how many beats we have. Stop the loop again and then use the frame by frame button. The last R wave is missing. We can see them because the red X, like before, is missing in the end. Use the red vertical reference markers in the period selector. Drag and drop the red markers to select the desired cardiac cycle. It's also possible to exclude the first beat. For that case, please drag and drop the red markers on the left side. We have now successfully set the R waves and the heart cycle. Please double check the end diastolic phase and then go frame by frame down to the end systolic phase. The recommendation of the task forces is to measure strain at the real end systolic phase. For that, we are going frame by frame and double check the timing information. If the timing information is not correct, feel free to adjust them. Leave the menu on the right upper corner. Okay, second example. In this case, you can see we have no ECG information transferred from the machine as a DICOM information. In this case, we have to set the ECG manually. We can use M-mode as a helping guide. For that, go with your mouse in the sign loop. You can see a pen appears. Left mouse click, and right mouse click to confirm. Play the loop to see how many heart cycles we have. In this case, it seems to be two heart cycles. We're gonna stop again and then go frame by frame to see if we really have two beats. The first thing I do is set my first R wave, the end diastolic phase information. I'm playing the loop, looking for the second R wave. Click one time with the left mouse. And then double check the last R wave. In this case, we can see the R wave, the third R wave is cutted again. And on the right mouse click, I can exclude the third R wave. I'm now drag and drop my red markers to exclude the second beat. And then finally, I will double check my end systolic phase information to measure the strain in the correct phase of the ECG, adjust it, and then exit and confirm.